Oh man, I could just stay here forever.
Beautiful. Same with me.
It's stunning, but it's time to go on, right?
And I have a feeling that around the corner, it's gonna be a place like this.
Yeah, it's time to go see new places, but we should definitely come back here again sometime.
Definitely.
Alright. Let's go.
Let's go.
Let's go. Thank you so much.
Great.
Take care.
Since we'd spent almost two whole days at our campsite near Vagamon, we were now faced with a new challenge. We only had about 2.5 days left before Casper had to catch a flight to return home from Kochi. So time was limited, but the list of places we still wanted to visit wasn't. Obviously though, choices had to be made. We could either take the shortest and fastest route to any one place and use the time thereafter to explore that place before riding further to Kochi. Or we could take the longer and slower routes and see more places along the way instead of at any specific destination. We unanimously agreed that the latter was the better choice.
So we're at Mullikanam and now we're taking this road towards Moolamattam.
Broadly, our target was to find our way to Munnar and then onward to Kochi. But the next few days were going to be about enjoying the Kerala roads more than anything else.
Last night was omelette in coconut oil.
It wasn't that bad actually.
Yeah, omelette in coconut oil is not that bad.
It works fine.
BTW. I think you can, it's fine to slurp these. Water's over.
Uppukannu viewpoint.
Uppukannu viewpoint.
Uppukannu viewpoint. Alright, back to the highway.
Kerala is particularly challenging to navigate through, in a good way. It gives you a few too many options. The road network across the state is like an intricate web, with roads branching away from each other ever so often, only to combine again somewhere down the line. Maybe 1 kilometer later, maybe 100 kilometers later. So technically, there are almost no wrong turns. But at the same time, the side you take at any intersection could drastically alter your journey experience. Since none of us had traveled through any of these roads before, most of our directional decisions had to be made on impulse.
A little bit of food and the rain came down, so the timing was perfect. Now we're just trying to find a place to stay around here in Idukki. Hi!
Oh, that's the Idukki Arch Dam. Look at that. What a random sequence of events. Anyway, we're here. Now let's try to get a room at a reasonable price. One of the worst things about Kerala is that all the signboards are in Malayalam. Here and there you may find some with some English, but most of them are all Malayalam. So you can't be relying on the signboards to get you where you want to go. You'll have to ask people or navigate, or just have Abhijit Nag to do the navigation. Came to see the Ponmudi Dam. It's like a tongue twister. Ponmudi Dam. This is pretty lovely. What's the story, Morning Glory? All the water's on the other side. I assume whenever they open up the dam, this place gets quite beautiful. Must be like a waterfall here. Yeah. This is the Hanging Bridge of Ponmudi. Ooh, this is quite cool.
Late in the afternoon, on the second day after we left Vagamon, we finally entered Munnar, a hill station that is also sometimes referred to as the Kashmir of the South and is famous for its expansive tea plantations rolling down the mountains all around it.
A few kilometers away from Munnar, we're in Munnar district now. We had a very random ride today. We took an interesting route, but the route wasn't that awesome. It's hit or miss here in Kerala. I mean, you just got to keep trying different things, and sometimes it works out, sometimes it's just so-so, but it's fun. I mean, overall, the ride is fun. But finally, we're in Munnar. I've been here once before, but it's good to be back again with good company. And it's good to see views like these again.
We didn't have much time to really explore Munnar, but we did have a few hours of daylight left. So before we went to find a place for us to stay the night, we used whatever time we had to ride around as much as we could, near, around, and through some of the famous tea gardens of Munnar. Thank you.
This is a real breakfast.
Simple. In Kerala, simple. Yes.
Yeah, of course.
In Kerala, of course.
This is steep.
Before we knew it, another day had dawned and it was time to head to Kochi. None of us wanted to leave the hills yet. None of us wanted to head back into the heat and chaos of a big city. In fact, we even tried convincing Casper to postpone his ticket and stay for longer. But he really had to get back. So after vowing to return again someday with a lot more time on our hands, we stuck to a plan for a change and rode back to Kochi together. GoPro to GoPro.
Bye GoPro.
Bye GoPros.
Bye GoPro.
This is it. This is the goodbye.
This is the goodbye for now.
For now.
But it was great fun riding with you.
Bye Casper.
I can't.
Go away now.